We're expanding Gemini way beyond phones, because a truly smart and helpful assistant should be there with you across all your devices and adapt to the way you use them. On a run, in the car, or even on the couch, your assistant should be ready to go. In the coming months, we're bringing Gemini to your watch on Wear OS. It's really helpful to have Gemini on your wrist in the moments when your phone isn't handy. Hands covered in flour while cooking, rushing between meetings, or in the middle of a bike ride. There's no need to get the words just right or awkwardly type into a tiny screen. Just talk naturally. So when I'm at the locker room in the gym and I've already put my phone away, I can still set a reminder for myself like, remember I'm using locker 43 today. And Gemini can understand me even when I'm in the middle of exercising. So I can ask, where's the restaurant Emily emailed about for tonight? And there it is. I didn't even need to pause my workout. Gemini is also coming to cars, starting with Android Auto in the upcoming months, followed by cars with Google built in. Gemini is really good at understanding what I want while I'm driving, whether it's local information or a fun podcast. So instead of focusing on the perfect prompt or tapping the right button, I can stay focused on the road ahead. And it's not just finding the best route, it's about helping you along the way. Gemini can help me find a charger that's on the way to the post office that's also near a park so that I can go for a walk while my car is charging.
Here are some vehicle charging stations near Vasona Park.
And rather than just reading my messages, Gemini can summarize them.
Your mom said she wants to hang out this Saturday since the weather will be nice and suggested a picnic.
I can tell Gemini, let's meet up at the beach, add a sunshine emoji, and translate it into Korean before sending.
All right, message to mom saying, 해변에서 만나요, with a sunny emoji.
Okay, now one other thing that I'm really excited about is Gemini Live, which can help me take advantage of all those hours I spend in the car. I can just ask, give me a quick rundown of the news today, but leave out sports.
Here's a quick rundown of some of the top news headlines today, Tuesday, May 13th, 2025.
It can even help me out of a jam. Like if I'm on my way to book club, and really I finished the book, but totally forgot what happened. I can say, give me a quick synopsis and a couple of good points for discussion.
Pride and Prejudice. Here's a quick rundown. In the English countryside, the witty and independent Elizabeth Bennet clashes with the proud and aloof Mr. Darcy.
Now, what about when you're back at home for the night? Later this year, Gemini capabilities are coming to your TV too. With Gemini on Google TV, I can ask for action movies that are age-appropriate for my kids and get the best recommendations. And TV isn't just for entertainment. I can help my kids explore their endless questions about the solar system. Gemini pulls up the perfect YouTube video and explains how it's basically like a giant playground filled with stars and planets. Perfect for my first grader. Okay, so Gemini is on the small watch screen, your screen on wheels, and the biggest screen in your living room. And hey, what about the infinite screen? Later this year, Gemini is also coming to Android XR. As you might have heard, Google and Samsung are collaborating on Android XR, a new platform for extended reality devices, headsets, glasses, and everything in between. Gemini unlocks powerful new ways to interact with these next-gen devices. Imagine Gemini helping you plan a vacation by surrounding you with videos, maps, and local tips, creating an entire itinerary in minutes within a rich, immersive experience. We'll share more on Android XR at I/O next week. With Gemini coming to all these new devices, we're bringing personalized smart help wherever you are, on whatever Android device you're using.